can see the lineups right here. Exile5 now consisting of Baldino, Momentum, and Zerkil.
But regardless of that, you can't rule out X5. They're such an aggressive team. X5 are hot, man. They're hot. They're real good right now. It's unquestionable. Momentum and the gang, Bald, Zerkil, Dino, just playing absolutely superbly. Wonderful, confident gameplay. They're really making very few mistakes, and it shows. And now we're going to one more cap here between these two absolute titans. What a game we have on our hands.
Exile5, dude, like, that's a hype train that's really hard to not jump on. Versus Exile5, as you can see here from this bracket, Nuke and Pave, they got the 3-0 over Best BR. Now going to be taking on Exile5, who performed brilliantly at the ANZ Regional Finals. Exile5 and Nuke and Pave, you can see the lineups right here. Exile5 now consisting of Baldino, Momentum, and Zerkil.
So it's going to be Empire Strongholds, Colli, Slayer, and Fathom CTF. If we can get there, Rig Strongholds and Plaza Slayer will be our deciders. And here we go, Juna capturing red base. This could be all she wrote for X5 here on Empire. It looks like both bases now being captured. Trip cap is now going to be theirs, but I think at this stage there's nothing more that X5 can do. They will be falling here in game one, and a superb start from the boys in blue. NAP looking very, very strong here.
Colosseum Slayer. We're going to have Nuke and Pave versus Exile5.
Back to these sort of traps that are being set here by the boys from Exile5. So superb stuff from them. 20-8. This game is really walking away very, very quickly and comfortably now for the boys from X5.
But up next, it is going to be a CTF on Fathom.
This game, let's have a look at him. Actually, Bald's got camo and rail. That's something I do want to see, to be completely honest. Now he's got the flag. So frankly, Bald has literally everything he can pick up in this game. Wonderful shot there on Armada, going for that reload. His teammates are in position to do something here. No, but Junior brings down the momentum once again. Junior just doing a phenomenal job, absolutely phenomenal job of slaying out X5. He whiffed his teammate just almost there. Wonderful stuff from Bald. Back-to-back kills this railgun.
Looks now like Momentum, I believe, yeah, he's got the flag for X5. Now we'll stay on board with the X5 flag because we do have a couple of kills coming out there. Junior, shots on the back. We've got Bald creeping in on foot. I'm actually going to just dive around a little bit to try and catch these players. Armada gets brought down there in blue base. Oh, we might be missing the action here, guys. Dino's going to get that flag return. And there it is. We are going to get that first cap on the board. Well done, OX5. I'm glad we didn't stray too far from the action there. So wonderful stuff from them. That second flag is now on the move. Looks like we've got Zerk Bald. God, he ran that so fast. We've barely got to see it. He's already made it to his base, but he did get taken out there in the doorway. And Wiggins, potentially in a position to stop someone.
No, stop it.
He didn't.
Stop
he
it.
Didn't push. He didn't extend. And now the cap came rolling in there. Momentum put that one away. Dunked it. No problem.
Now you've got Zerkly here for XR5, just trying to maintain control of the map. They've got the lead here 2-0. I think it would be a really big deal if Exile5 gave up any kind of momentum here, because Nuke and Pave, they're on the back foot. They're scrambled here. There's no way they can really come back if Exile5 just keep playing the way that they are.
Across again, they're really trying to force those spawns towards the silo side. You can see that big B on the screen. That's really what they want. That's really where X5 rather want NAP to be spawning after they kill them out. So wonderful stuff there. There's that first kill. Dino managing to kill Armada. Bald got killed of his own. So there's a nice double for Dino. Wonderful positioning from him. Couple more shots out. Can he get Rabbi? He does. Triple kill somehow. Wonderful play from him. But he will be killed.
A generous triple kill.
Very generous triple kill. Here's that final flag. Potentially Zerk's managed to get it all the way across the map. Can he get the cap here? But Wiggins on the spot does get brought down. Oh, glorious run there. Fantastic kill from Dino. The final moments there to seal the deal for his team. And Zerk runs that one home. Glorious, glorious finish there. 3-0,
Jonics. Map number 4. Exile5 going to take it, man.
X5 going to take it? All right,
nah,
man.
No, they're probably not.
NAP going to take it.
Let's have a quick look and see how Armada's going to be utilizing this camo, because he fought very hard to get it, Mars.
He did a great job getting it. Now, unfortunately, he's in a very difficult spot. He's going to be hunted down there by a couple of members of X5. Takes the shield momentum. Doesn't manage to get that kill. Oh no. He caught him out.
Oh, man.
The trap was set. X5 now clawing their way back into this one. But look at that. Capturing now the nest. Look at this positioning from Zerkil. Superb shots. Don't know how he managed to actually get both of those kills without being contested there. And now he's going to get a railgun.
See, I think just as fast, Nuke and Pave ends back. They've now got control of the second stronghold again. But this one a lot closer than what we saw in our first stronghold game.
Yeah, it's a lot closer at the stage. But look, I mean, we've still got a decent lead, you know, being developed here by NAP. Regardless of that, you can't rule out X5. They're such an aggressive team, such tenacity. They're really not going to let this one go out.
42-41 as Exile5 take the lead in this Strongholds match. If they win this one, they get the W up against Nuke and Pave.
Way Armada goes down. Wigan's trying to do what he can. Railgun's up, but it's not going to be enough. 100 to 51. Exile 5 take that one. End the series 3-1 versus Nuke and Pave. We're going to a winner's bracket final. Exile 5 versus Pink Mist. Enough. Which is going to be Pink Mist versus Exile 5. Well, let's take a look at the maps we're going to be playing. We've got a new roster of maps coming up in just a second, I'm sure. I would love to see a game 5 winner's bracket final. We shall soon see how it's going to go down. Let's head straight into the action. Will it be Exile 5 or the team of Pink Mist?
It's really confusing for everyone watching at home because some of the gamer tags still say X5 of them, but they're not on that team anymore.
Yeah.
But yeah, good looking start for Pink Mist. For X5, they've got an early set of kills, and now we've got Bald with that snipe. Flag is already on the move. We are going to be following on board with Bald as he slays out these players. I may take a quick look at that flag runner as he starts to move it. Oh, just whiffing. Slazy shot there. Does get the head in the end. And that flag is still moving now, as you can see on your screen. Zirkel running that one through. He will potentially be able to get that cap. I don't think anyone's in place to stop it. And there we go, ladies and gentlemen. First cap on the board. Early cap on the board.
Yeah, forced to back up. Right across mid, you know, he doesn't get tagged up, so that's really lucky that he's able to get away. Spots that player, picks up the kill. Now there's Bald, he goes down as well. So maybe if they just take down that one last player, which I think was Zirkel, they might have had a chance. Brad goes in, collapses on him. Oh, but Brad goes down. I thought that was going to be the return, but you can see there's no blue players around. This is the chance. Dino forced out, flag returned, and now we're going to be all tied up here at night. And I'm just having a look across this map, and it seems that no one's over Rocket Side just yet. But it seems to be very much, it was a blue team sniper area until everyone just really pushed out. And now you've got XR5 pushing in to try and get sniper control. On the other side of the map, you might be seeing XR5 push up towards that rocket area. But a bit hard to tell right now as Brattle's going to get the full shot with that BR. Takes up another kill on Zirkel, getting the double kill. Gets the triple as well before being rocketed. Yeah, it is indeed. The pressure is just too much. XR5 are ahead right now though, 2-1.
On the other side of the map, there's a little bit of an engagement going. Bald versus Pip. Oh my good God, Bald gets the revenge on Pip. He does get the kill on him.
Pray for Pip. He got destroyed.
Pray for Pip once more.
And Bald again. Now Colt just watching the back. The spawner's coming out. Now they've just got to watch out for the players who will spawn over Rocket Side. I think there's actually a player in their base, and he does pull the flag. So they need to stop him. That's going to be Zirkel. Colt doing what he can to stay alive. You can see two players there from the blue team. Both go down, but the flag is out. It is now 40 seconds left. Colt, he needs his teammates to recover this flag.
Here we go. Colt is sitting now, sitting pretty on red plat. He does have help with his teammates. He is going to be able to keep that flag alive now. I'm going to jump over to... Oh, Zirkel just got killed. It looks like we could be seeing that cap. Colt moving back in for it. And there we go. 30 seconds remaining. They've just tied this one up. They're going to be forcing us to a final cap or even overtime if we need it. My good God, what a game between these two teams. It is such a personal game. A lot of history between the two of them. A lot of very funny internet videos if you're Bald or Pip. And now we're going to one more cap here between these two absolute titans. What a game we have on our hands.
Through
fine. Bald does have the flag, I believe, or actually maybe Zerk now running that flag home. His team does, this is it. This could potentially be it. They've got the manpower, they've got the positioning. Bald might be able to run this one home, and he does. Wonderful job from X5 to scrap that cap together in the final moments.
Exile5 taking the first one, heading into an Eden Slayer up next. Watch his right though, because those players are going to be on that outside. Spots the player down low, picks up the kill, that's a killing spree. But now the opposing team are going to know where he is. Brad just misses out on him, gets the double kill, switches over the snipe. This is a potential overkill material if he turns around.
He's got the... Not making too much of it being killed by the opposing team, and the opposing team grabbing it. I do not want to stray away from Zirkel though, because right now he's dicing with death. Nice shot there, does land it. Oh God, so close.
It's a good bait though.
I'm going to jump on board. Dino's moving in close range. Good shot there. Zerk gets pips. Would he get another one? No, he manages to thrust away and stay alive. His teammates now, he's got Bald with those rockets still. I'm going to jump over and have a look at Bald in just a moment. But oh, Slazy getting hit by that no-scope body shot. He's only got 3 shots left from that snipe. He's making him count with a headshot there on Slazy. They may receive pips with that shot. Oh, he's going to call. No, wait a minute. What is happening? My mouth. I can't take this. My heart. Pips managing to get the turn. Oh, my man.
Spots one, bottom security, call out's going to go to Slays. They know they only need one more kill. It looks like it's going to go down over in generators. Brattles picks up the kill, and the turnaround from Pink Mist, 50 to 43.
It was 3-2 as Coliseum captured the flag, which really went down to the absolute wire. And a phenomenal comeback from Pink Mist to win that game 50-43 on Eden Slayer. What the hell will Plaza Strongholds have in store for us? Why don't we find out? Opting not to recapture yard, instead going for bottom middle. I like that. Prioritizing that stronghold, which is far harder to control.
Which he got instantly thanks to that shotgun.
Shot, he was a good grab. He abandoned the yard, lost nest quite quickly, but again, shotgun is just brutal damage up close. I mean, look at the kills he's picking up here. I'm not even sure that counts. It's a shotgun kill. It's so far away. Brattle's now controlling the nest, does his best to recapture that one. There's a trip cap, and ladies and gentlemen, I think this is going to be all she wrote for X5 here on Plaza Strongholds. Pink Mist will be taking the first lead here in this series, 100-25.
Convincingly.
Damn convincingly.
Map number four, potentially our last winner's bracket final. ANZ Championship, the Halo 5 playoffs presented by Plantronics. Let's get into it.
How can he, what can he do? Looks like he's gonna slow this one down slowly but surely. It looks like X5 have actually just pulled Pink Mist's flag. Look at this, Brattle's big long range rocket does get the damage on D, not to find the kill. Momentum picks up a couple of kills on stage, so that's two members of actually X5 getting those kills. So Brattle's still rocks in hand, we can see on the other side of the screen. Zirkle running that one home. Oh, good God, that's it. Zirkle's going to be able to get that one in because Brattle's, he was just shut down there. He wasn't able to make anything happen with those rockets. Pip's trying to make something happen now, but it's going to be all too late as he will be getting that flag cap in 1-0 on the board.
Oh,
for Pips.
Pips.
Nice big double for Pips. He's going to try and get out here through the hail of X5's fire.
Yeah, this is a good run. Slay's backing him up. Brattle's got the five shot as well. Slay's able to get away, but Dino's on his tail. Dean finally taken down. That flag is a long way away, though. Colt should be able to get it. He eats a nade for his trouble, though. You can see he is going to be spotted, but able to get away with his flag. Nade's coming in. He throws it out. Who's that? That's going to be a couple of players pushing in for the blue team. Oh, just getting away with that flag, but it should be returned. Colt should be in here for the Pygmy squad, and he does indeed get that cap. So a great return cap.
Yeah, back to square one. It looks like that flag being run. I believe it's Pips, who's got OS as well. This is a very, very good opportunity for them by managing to secure that overshield. He's still got 30% of it. Oh man, that's not even a problem. 5 minutes remaining. He's going to jump for him, see if he can't make that flag happen. He does take it the right way, thank good God this time. He does have some setup with his team. They've got that top lane covered. Shotty side of the map is theirs. Dean is back at his base, making sure that no one is sneaking in, making anything happen there. And look at this fast run from him. Dean with one kill there on Pips. He's got another player contesting. Good job with the thrust. And there we are, all back to 2-2. Wonderful run from Momentum. Coordinated that perfectly with his teammates.
It was overtime, wasn't it? Where Exile5 were able to scrap together that final cap. And now you've got Pink Mist in control of rockets once again, and he's gonna stop this flag pull. That's going to be clutch. Potential here for a triple. He does get that, makes it look easy. Overkill potential as well. Long range rocket out to try and get it, and he does get it. That's going to be the overkill for Colt. Potential for a kill tack as well. Is he going to get it? It's right there, right at the end. He could have got it. Who cares about the kill tack?
Oh,
Pink
man.
Mist actually get the win, all because of that overkill. Here we are, lower bracket final, Exile5 versus Nuke and Pave.
What we do here is go back.
I gotta work on the crazy eyes.
Yeah.
Zerg's got that flag, he's making the run. That's gonna be a cap. Good lordy. What a run! Just boxing in there. Up, but alas. There's another flag, just in case. Oh, here, you dropped this, guys.
Flag is out, but it may just get in there. You can see the flag's at home. Gotta just stomp that one in. 3-1 to Exile5 in that previous CTF. Now we're back on truth, this time for a Slayer. This is the ANZ Championship Halo 5.
Looking absolutely superb in this game. Look at this positioning, shots on from Zirkle. He's all over the map, in your face, in your grill. Armada's going to drop straight into a splinter nade in the face.
They won the CTF 3-1. Now looking into the Slayer, 50-37. Looks like where we're going to finish it up with Momentum getting that last kill on Rabbi. Beautiful stuff there from Exile5, potentially the last map if Exile5 can lock this one down.
41-4 with several trip caps to their name. X5 just looking absolutely superb. And Momentum's getting doubles of his own. Zirkle's getting called, kills all over the place. Balls has got a scatter shot, and there we go, guys. Victory, Exile5, comfortably, and I mean comfortably, walking 3-0 over NAP.
As for the lower bracket, Exile5 had a pretty decent run as well. Obviously, they were eliminated in the winner's bracket final, so they only had one loser's bracket match. It was a loser's bracket final up against Nuke and Pave. We just had it, and that was a very rough 3-0 for Nuke and Pave. Exile5, just too good, which, of course, brings us to the grand final. Gentlemen, And ladies, I don't know why I reversed that order there, but applause please for both of these teams. So our format for this is going to be another best of five. Pink Mist as the winners of the winners bracket final. They only need to win this best of five to take the grand final. However, if Exile5 form a comeback on this best of five, we'll play another best of five to then determine the winner.
Some lovely stuff from them. Trip cap ahoy for Pink Mist. How's this one going to play out? They now need an absolutely flattened red base. Now, Bald will be first in the line. Oh, and there it is. Two right-handers will take down Bald. Slazy now moving on to his next target. Who will the next victim be? Will it be Zirkle?
Shot four out. Players from Exile5 were just dropped, so Pink Mist have formed a really amazing comeback right here. Secured it brilliantly. They're now in the lead. They're pushing into blue base just to get the defense as well. Taking down one. Slaze goes for a second as well. That was going to be a 9 points. The last point happening right here. 100-44 is going to be the score. Pink Mist now two maps away from taking the grand final here.
Let's do it.
Momentum. He was an animal, man. He was an animal in the last series and, you know what, throughout the entire day. So let's watch him right here as he's going to get one of the first kills of this match here. It's up, and now the snipe is going to be in the hands of Momentum as well as he gets a double.
Completely trying to envelop his players in the yard. Great shot from him there. Colt removed his head and a double. Lovely play on Slazy there. Going to apply surgical precision to ever so slowly eradicate them. Lovely no-scope. Brad does get taken down there. Momentum with another snapshot. Snipes have been pretty delicious so far, and they're not getting any worse. He's got one shot left, and I'm sure he'll make it count. This is a whole new beast. We've got Pips and Dino having a bit of a fight, and that's what they needed. Dino's shields are down, and there we go. Easy pick from Colt. They're two kills away now. Bald unit caught out in middle. Doesn't manage to do anything there, and look at this. Because of that positioning, though, he doesn't manage to let those players through. We've got 45-47. Oh. OS has just respawned. No one is going to be able to get that, I don't think. Actually, Zirkle in mid-map with that green gun doesn't manage to get it. It looks like Momentum has OS. I'm going to jump over to Momentum and see what he can do with this one. He does have a sniper rifle coming up soon. But look at this positioning. Braddle's out in mid-map. Can he make something happen here? Goes for the ground pound. Doesn't need to do it. Well done at X5. 50-47. They did not choke it. Wow. What a game.
Yeah, I mean, Colt, he's been doing the work. He has stayed alive for a very, very long time. He's still got the railgun as well, which is all going to be handy. Meanwhile, though, Slaze is going to be able to make a run here for Pink Mist, but the flag is going to be pulled. Zerk should be getting the return there for Exile5. So now this is a real chance for Momentum and the rest of Exile5. It's looking like a cap here, in fact.
What a fantastic turnaround. That was a counter cap. That was the counter cap from Kevin Josh. I mean, look, stealth cap, you name it. And now, wonderful positioning from Momentum. He's going to be able to get those kills on those guys mid-map straight away to top mid. I love this. And he's got that flag. Looks like Braddles and Colt will be running that flag. Treehouse side. Can Pink Mist make something happen here? They're still playing for their tournament here. They only need to win one more series in order to win this the tournament, get that cash, and everybody can go home. But alas, Dino says no.
Exile5 trying to make the comeback story of the day. Shots ringing out. Colt's going to be right in front. He's got that railgun charged up. That player somehow managing to stay alive. Two, as I mentioned, cleaned up by Dino. He got two kills, and now that flag's going to be run. This actually should be a cap, considering the kills that we just saw. If Dean can just stay alive and prevent any kind of push down that street, it's going to be pretty easily capped. But here for Exile5, and Dino goes down at the hands of Colt, who picks up two. So this is an opportunity. If Momentum goes down as well, you can see he does. So this is a great opportunity to run this flag here, as Pips is going to turn around and get the return of his own flag as well. This should be a cap. You should be seeing Pink Mist on the board here against Exile5.
Here is the potential comeback. How can Colt stay alive in mid-map? No, he cannot. Pips, the only man left alive for his team there on Porch, doing a lot of damage there. 1v1 against Momentum. Momentum does get the better of him there. Zirkle now pushing up from his base, trying to deal with those players who were on spawn for Pink Mist, and now he's dealing with them from behind, which is just perfect timing. The timing of this push is excellent. He does have to move out now. One member of his team, I think Momentum, running that flag. Again, you can see on his screen there, a few players in position that they've come pouring through sub. Now, this is the last cap, potentially. He does get brought down on the doorstep. His teammate does. He didn't manage to get the flag through the window, so he does have to have a teammate push in, grab that flag, get it up on through. And look at this, one member of Pink Mist going in for the desperate return. And I think, ladies and gentlemen, that is going to be it. Oh my good giddy aunt. Good golly, Miss Molly.
What are we seeing right here? Exile5 take the second map in a row. Exile5, one map away from forcing his second best of five. Pink Mist looking to lock this one down. They need the next two maps to take away the grand final and the lion's share of $3,000 cash. in prizes. Now momentum, let's watch him again. He's just been an animal throughout this entire series.
Bolds. Spartan charge there was so perfectly timed that he managed to get the kill there, because one BR shot the momentum put into Pips, which is great stuff there. So first cap on the board for X5.
For the Pink Mist squad, they're back into the triple cap territory, taking down Dino. He's on the killing spree. Look at this guy move. Colt has just been amazing, getting shots out. Down goes Zirkle as well. Colt looking for more. He's hungry for it. The Splinter Nade, he just punches it away. He's not worried. Gets the distraction medal, and you can see he's not done yet.
Regain my confidence in Pink Mist at this stage, but well done to them for capturing that bottom mid. And just like that, it's all going to turn around.
Yeah, it's going to completely turn around, and Pink Mist are going to be locking this one down. Thanks to Colt, who had such an amazing game, along with the rest of Pink Mist. We're going to be finishing this one up 100-61.
Not a bad comeback.
What a way for a grand final to go down, ladies and gentlemen. Four maps down. We're sitting 2-2 in the series. We're heading into game 5. Let's get into it. It's going to be a thriller, I am sure.
Nope, nobody in position. Oh, here we go. Slazy gets a couple of shots out. Whoa, momentum. Not fooled whatsoever. Read him like a book on that thrust. That he was not to be had. I don't even think Slazy knew that that rocket kill was coming his way. And look at this push. Wonderful collapse just about to happen here. Down by Turbine. Well done to Zirkle there. Manages to get one. Can he get a second one on the reload? Oh, and he does manage to do all the damage. Will he get the kill? No, he doesn't. Pressure is now on. Bald taken down there from Pip. He does need to help out his team. Momentum does get a kill and shots out Momentum. Can he do it? Oh my God! Where did Dino come from at the final moment there to kill Pip? But it really looked like Momentum was going to win that 1v1 SMG at like half shield. Goodness.
We need to watch Momentum. 15 to 10. So you can see here, slowly but surely, Pink Mist making a little bit of a comeback. Kills being traded out there. Everyone able to dodge these rockets. Now Ball trying to get the sneaky shots out with that sniper as well. Able to stay alive somehow. Actually, this is a bit of a work of art.
It's managing preposterous.
To duck and weave around here. How is Ball still alive? He finally goes down. And a player left.
And as we say it, sadly, we did just lose Colt, so the game will be ended. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm terribly sorry.
When we left it, it was 14 to 12 with Exile5 in front. So now, as you look at the scoreboard, as we start things off, you want Exile5 to get 36. Pink Mist to get 38.
Rocks in hand, Colt, sniper, yes. Effective, but you know, it's like, oh, I had to grab it. Oh, that's just waiting for his options. Lovely snipes. Looking at Colt's got his new rockets, two in hand, 16 to 8 right now. Wonderful stuff there out of Pink Mist. Again, they're playing for the tournament here. X5 are playing at the shot of resetting the series
by 7 points technically.
Dino caught out in the open in a very bad way as Colt pushes on three. He potentially could get another one here, but what a kill from Zirkle with that shotgun. Let's have a quick look at Bald. Zirkle unfortunately brought down there. He managed to overextend the lone sap without the help of his sniper. Oh, and snipe on snipe action. Slazy falls to the might of the Kiwi Hope. One kill. Now he can use that sniper. Oh. Second the double. Can he get another? Wonderful work from him. He's going to use that sniper's bait to bring those players out. On the turn, Momentum managing to stay alive. Wonderful work from him and fantastic plays. He still actually brought him down there. Pips got brought down by Zirkle. And here comes the push out for that sniper rifle. It is still like a trap. The lure has been set and the trainers are now gathering around it.
So great teamwork from both teams. Right now, it just seems to be Pink Mist a little bit on top. Pips going to be forced back. Splinter Nades out. And you know, Colt knew where that player was going to be down bottom of red base. So wisely backing up. I'd like to see him turn back with that sniper as well, unless he's got a teammate watching the flank, because that player is still going to be behind him. In fact, that's where they're all going to be spawning from. So he turned around, but it was probably just a little too late, unfortunately.
Oh. Wonderful shots from Colt. I mean, really brilliant stuff. He's got rockets now spawning 28 to 19, 20 to 28. The kills are coming thick and fast between these two teams. Beautiful work from Colt. Another kill on Balls there, picking up that Top Gun medal. He still has snipe. He's got one shot left in it. He did not get rockets, though. Rockets are now in the hands of XR5. Potential for a comeback is certain. Will it actually happen, though?
Keep in mind that Pink Mist only need to get to 38. They are 8 kills away from victory, 16 kills away for the boys in blue, Exile5.
Rocket kills, actually, just jump aboard with Zirkle. He doesn't have any rockets left, I believe. One left in the chamber. Let's have a look at those player outlines, because let's face it, it's not going to be too surprising anymore. Rocket also on the field, 3 uncontested kills there. Wonderful stuff from X5. And this positioning, Pip's actually going to be caught bottom middle, but no one's going to be able to punish him there. It does look like Zirkle is in a decent spot to push him, but maybe not punish him. And there's a player in security right next to him as well. Nice shot there on Colt. He doesn't actually get the kill, but does finally clean him up. And there is an engagement with Pips, now charging him one-on-one. Spawners in blue behind him as well. Zirkil doing an amazing job of staying alive, but I may have spoke to a little too soon. As back on board with Colt at top, 32-26.
Exile5, they need to get to 36. So they're now 9 kills away.
Although they have just changed their angle. This is a very important ball. Might be able to get this kill here. This is tremendous if he does. Does manage to land the shot on Braddles going
perfectly.
For it. Beautiful stuff. He may be able to nade that one out, but look at this slightly overambitious play. They're just edging forward and lovely stuff. He needs to get his pistol out and no need because Momentum's going to get that kill. Zirkil gets Colt as well. And look at the respawners coming out of red base, not managing to get anyone. Doesn't even land a body shot, sadly, but he does tie things up. 31-32. My God, this is really going down to the wire.
Four kills to the 5 of Pink Mist. Shots coming out, ringing out right here, 34. So 4 kills required for both teams right here. 34 kills
oh
now
my
to
God.
The blue team of Exile5. Ridiculous stuff from Momentum. Only 2 more kills required for Exile5. I apologize for the confusion, guys, if you're just tuning in. We had to restart this match. So only 2 kills required for Exile5 to force another best of 5. 4 kills required. Look at this, 35 kills for Exile5. They need one more. Looking for 36 right here. And there it is.
Oh,
Exile5.
Oh, my God. No way.
Oh, man.
No
what
way.
A comeback. What
no
a comeback.
Way. No way. That was insane.
Ridiculous. Ridiculous. Exile5 now forcing us into another best of 5.
God damn.
But Pink Mist, type
Q for Exile5.
Ow, let's do it.
Lock it up. Here we go, guys. It's going to be coming from that general direction. Nice 1v1 engagement between Pips. There we are. Pips does bring him down. It's a back over. We're going to have a look. See if we can't find something on the other side of the map. Bald to return. 2 members dead for Exile5. This is going to spell doom. Here they come. Wonderful awareness from Bald. Rocket play out from Colt. Doesn't manage to get the kill. Doesn't actually hit with a second either. So he is going to be alive. Well done from Bald staying alive. You little cockroach managing to survive all of that. Brilliant double from Dino as well. Wow, look at this change. Now, I like this play from Bald. He's abandoning the flag just for that small window of opportunity they've just been given by getting those kills. Can he make something happen? No, those players are now back on respawn. He has to go back for the flag. Wonderful play from him. Actually, 2 kills apiece. There's the return. Oh my good God, could this be it? Pips is in position to make something happen and he chokes the beatdown. No, Pips, why you do this?
Pips just can't take down Bald in these 1v1 scenarios, man.
And there we go. Bald unit once again running that flag, doing sublime objective work for his team. Josh, what is going on?
The man was seeing an Exile5 comeback in a huge way. You can see also Bald eating nades for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Now he's going to be taken down and that flag will be returned. So that was actually a clutch play from Colt, but he didn't get away with the flag. Exile5 still in front, 1-0 though. So
it's really going down the wire, Josh.
It is indeed. You know, this is some great moves from the Exile5 squad. Under 4 minutes left, they just need to hang in there. They keep applying the pressure, which is great. Being in front by only 1 flag, you don't want to just stay defensive. You don't want to just stay in your base or on your side of the map. That's exactly where, the majority of teams lose their CTFs, you know? As soon as they have that, just that 1 cat lead, they try and stay super defensive, but as soon as you get slayed out, your spawns are all whack, and they're obviously going to be taking your flag. So I love the pressure that Team Exile5 keep putting on Pink Mist.
Here we are, amazing plays here. This could be the potential cap. Here we go, straight on a Zirkil. Does get in before I can even change over to him. Amazing stuff there. That shot he played, a complete open lane. Exile5 have got to burn the clock here. This is their chance. Bald with a nice kill on Pip from behind. Hoping to get that return. There's a splinter nade. Slazy coming in from behind. They do get the return, and there's the cap on the other side of the map. Colt put that one in. They've got 15 seconds to make something happen. If they do this, Josh, I will flip the table. I will try to flip this desk. I don't think I'll do it, but this
pretty
is insane.
I don't think it's possible.
I don't think it's possible. No one's in any position to do it. In 4 seconds, there is nothing they can do. Exile5 have put up a phenomenal fight in this first game. And despite the best efforts of Pink Mist, Exile5 got 1-0.
That's map number 2, this final best of 5 series here for the grand final. Pink Mist versus Exile5. Exile5, you can see the scoreboard. They're ahead 1-0 as we head into this Slayer on the ring.
I wonder how aware he is of ball spawn there, as we have the benefit of seeing that through spectator mode, and it looks like he is absolutely all over it. This is a perfect rotation. Ball is now absolutely trapped there in the bunker. He may get assassinated. Yep, give it to him, son.
Eventually.
That was just a face full of arse for quite a little bit too long there, if I'm honest. 15-9.
I'm receiving the end of this.
Ball can make more of this snipe against lovely position. Oh, carbine shots. That gave me a heart attack. I must admit, I'm not sure how Ball feels right now, but I leapt out my seat a little bit when that hit. Can he make something happen here? Plays that one. Catwalk going to be pushing up. They do have numbers now. Here comes the collapse. We are seeing Brettles moving on up. We're going to see if anybody can stay alive here. Ball has to do something. He must make that major rotation. But look, he has fully aware of those players making a push in from Carbine. Slazy does get the kill on Balls there. Let's have a quick look at maybe Slazy. We'll see Pip. He was making a nice flank round. They're rotating onto Bunker. Here we go. Couple more kills now, potentially in the bank.
Slazy with that scope though, he's going to pick up a kill straight away. That's Dino going to be dropping, looking for more as well. It always seems to be they get the scopes when we're not looking at them.
There it is, sniper in hand does miss that first shot, but this is a wonderful position for them to be in. Can he make something of this? Great shot there on Colt in the head, on the dash back there. Can he get pips as well? Yes, he does. Nice job protecting Bald there. Bald staying alive, and now they're one kill in this. Amazing work from X5. They're not out of this yet. They may have lost that first win the bracket game, but now in the grand finals, they are powering their way through this one. Exceptional work from the Huey.
From that 9-kill deficit they had a little earlier in the game, still taking faces. Is this Halo Esports or is this pornography coming from momentum right here in a way? Dean went down as well, and he could potentially give up his positioning and the last two rounds of the sniper. And you can see momentum. He tagged him up there, and he does actually get the kill on Slays. I'm not exactly sure how he got that kill.
I'm not exactly sure. Colt now, though.
Either way, he was taken down, and now we have a one-point game between these two teams.
Brattle's picking up a couple, tying things up. Ball somehow staying alive, but this nade should find its mark. Doesn't somehow get the kill, but the second one does find it. Brilliant start, 46 all. And look at this plasma cast, a huge play. Does get momentum. He needs a couple more. There's the double. Onto the wall, what a bank. The play on the ground pound. Colt with a triple, absolutely preposterous play. They need one more kill. Can he go and get it? One man army. It is all on Colt now, and he's charging in. Former teammate Bald, what's he gonna do? He's gonna charge in and help his teammate get that kill. Slazy with the Spartan charge to win it. 50, 46, my God, ladies and gentlemen. Pink Mist are back in this.
What an absolutely ridiculous finish. Map number three in this best of five series for our grand final.
Ombo with Zirkle now from the side of Red Base. Pip's now dealing with that flank. I like this play. And also Blue Bend actually also being captured in the background there. So now we do have two positions in the hands of X5, of Pink Mist rather. X5 now answering back. Superb shots there from Zirkle. Great awareness. Not falling prey to that. And just like I say, Slazy shoots, drops a crazy nade on him. And Zerk doing the kind of drunk stagger there, just hanging on the wall. You know that thing where you just, your legs don't work.
He's just trying to do, you know, sneaky leak there, to be honest, where he's positioned.
It's been a long day, right? He hasn't had too many breaks. Bald went to the double, actually, but Pip does bring him down. Two strongholds still in the hands on the XL5. They will be accumulating points. Going anywhere too soon. Dino, wonderful job getting in there just in time before that was, will potentially be reset there by the enemy team now. Bald just taking down up top Cat. We've got nades coming in from Dino. Wonderful denial of area there using those splinter grenades. They do spawn up top Red Nessa. Wonderful stuff from him. And now good shots cross map getting picked. Pip being just a tiny bit too aggressive. And she looks like Brad also caught bottom middle. So for some reason, Dino's managing to pick up double kills in bottom middle. And this is a potential triple. It could have been. Why not? And he does manage to secure that overshield absolutely perfectly. So wonderful stuff. Oh, wait a minute. Slazy, we're not going to let you get away with that one, son. That was a spanker miss at close range. Thankfully.
Two spankers.
Two spankers. That's one for each cheek. Thankfully, that overshield did manage to save Dino this time. And I'm excited to see how he's going to make this work. I don't think he's going to be able to do too much there. Caught out in the open, in between a thrust and a hard place. And that's a trip cap for X5. Bit of Dino love. Nope, he's dead. Sorry. Zirkle will be our man of choice. Wonderful plays there. But I really like watching how Pink Mist managed to get out of that triple cap. They captured both Catwalk and Blue Bend at pretty much the exact same time with a lovely two-man push to either position. And X5 didn't really have the manpower to deal with it. It was just an excellent way to get out of that and secure themselves a little bit of real estate here on EV. Of course, 42-36 right now. Zirkle, Dino with a triple with his assault rifle. That's what we like to see. Give him the overkill. Give it to him. Give it to him, dude. Just shout it out. There you go, Dino. It's all yours, mate. Zirkle doing what he can to kill that one. And again, trip cap now. Four. It was actually just momentarily four Pink Mist, and now we've got X5 answering back with a couple of caps of their own. There's the triple. Wonderful organization between the four of them. And now rockets are on spawn. I believe Bald is all alone there at Blue Bend. Can Circle get there in time to give him a hand? It looks like Dean has also showed up. And now Red Nest and Catwalk will be there. Oh, what a spanker. Here comes the plays with those rockets that we needed. Zerk doing what he can. Wonderful thrust shot for the double. Beautiful stuff. Giving Pips a little bit of a back whack and a bit of a body smack, and I love to see that. Superb shots here from Zirkle, loving his rocket work, and a little bit of a melee in the air to just let us know how much he enjoyed that kill, which is always nice to see. Triple cap now, still in effect. That rocket play, killing three of those players, exceptional stuff from Zerk, really buying his team the time they need.
Yeah, I mean, they've held on to the triple cap for about 60 seconds now, which has been great. They've got the lead 64 to the 51 of Pink Mist, and Bald's going to have this camo as well. Not doing too much work out in this lower catwalk, but hey, he's cleaning up kills, as you can see, with Brattles going down. Now he's going to be on the hunt for Pips as well, by the looks of it.
I love that positioning, putting him on mid-catwalk like that, you know, sitting out in the open. He had perfect visibility of pretty much every single stronghold he brought to. Now he can come up and get a real good back smack on Pip. I mean, that was very satisfying to watch. And a potential double on Brattles. Oh, but he does get a little... He gave him the old, you know, the switcheroo a little bit there. He almost gave him the dipsy doodle. That would have been a tragedy. But look at this, guys. X5, 84 to 51. That trick that X5 have got at the moment. They've still got Blue Bend in the hands. Although he's now being captured by momentum. Let's have a quick look and see what Slazy can do. He's charging on through. Two players now capturing Blue Bend. Great job there. The two of them managing to secure that one. And Slazy brought down in the open, getting averaged by momentum there. Let's have a look at momentum. He's had a great game so far. And there's the win, ladies and gentlemen. There was no need to jump across to anyone else. Anyone else's perspective. X5 take their second game of the series, 100 to 63. But man, I'm so pumped for this, because we're really coming close to the end of this one.
Now, if they can just continue this flag run, they're going to have a great opportunity here. But unfortunately, Slay's forced back because of Bald coming up behind them, getting the shots out. He does eventually finish that player off and go on that killing spree. He spots momentum trying to get the flank, calls it out to his teammate. Meanwhile, Colt has been able to make an amazing run, throws that flag out, but momentum's right there. Now, Slazy, he needs to be careful, because he was actually completely called out by momentum. He took him down with that scatter shot. Now that flag might be returned. They need to pick it up here. Both teams trying to do what they can. Oh, this is going to be so close. Rockets in the hands of Colt. What can they do right here? That flag was actually returned, I believe. No, it's still alive, actually, over in the red base. So this is going to be so intense here.
They got it.
They finally got there, thanks to Brattles.
15, obviously, Bald is top rockets. Here we go, flag being run. I believe that's Circle moving that flag. Dean, not in any position to really slow this guy down or help him out. Look at that flag run. Actually, Dino getting a nice perfect kill on the other side of the map. We'll have a look at Momentum, who is running that flag. He's made it quite the distance. He is in his base, but he knows there's a member of Pink Mist in there rather. Now Colt doing what he can to keep his flag alive, but I think that return is inevitable at this stage. And there we go, 1-1. We're seeing it all over again, Josh. It's deja vu. We're literally living a Groundhog Day on Coliseum CTF here between these two teams. Right now, these players. Let's have a look at Pip, who's moving that flag now. Taking a fair bit of damage, but he is going to be making it halfway. It does get the flag to the grass, and I'm not sure if this is a good thing for them right now. No one's in position to really help him out. Slazy does kill Zirkle, but I'm not sure if it's enough. How many players can they push in front of these bullets to slow this one down from Slazy? Might just be able to get this one through unless we get a sniper in the back of the head, which we certainly will not be receiving. 2-1 right now. Pink Mist, Josh, looking strong.
Both the rocket and the snipe both play a major part in any kind of push. Generally what you'll see teams do is try and get rocket control and then move over the snipe, because that's generally the kind of way that you'll run flag over through caves. So expect that to potentially happen, but with flags being run out right now, anything could happen.
Dino's got to do what he can to stay alive. Health.
This is deja vu.
He's at half health. This is, we're going to absolutely, it was always going to be this way. It had already been written. You know, hold the door and all that. It's, you know, we're not exactly changing history. We're just seeing it happen for the very first time. And here we go. 2-2. Rockets now on spawn. Bald v. Pip. Here we go. The rematch.
This is where we were, and we saw Exile5 manage to walk away with the W. Will we see the same again?
I think it's very, very likely we'll see the same thing again. I'm not sure if Dean's going to be able to do too much with this flag to get it out. He's definitely going to be contending with those spawners any second now. And I don't think too many of his teammates are in position to help him out here. Oh, reloads that AR just at the wrong time. Sadly, that 50% shield is not going to be able to let him do too much. He does have those rockets, though, which is very, very handy. His teammates or somebody in the team transfer those over, gifted them to him. Here comes the assault. This could be it. X5 now on the offensive.
Pips,
he's doing it again. He's doing it again, the sneaky devil. There it is. Your flag's away. Guess who? It's Pips. That almost worked out. That almost worked out.
Imagine if that was like a direct hit. That would have been insane.
That would have been absolutely insane. Let's see what Pip's up to. He's staying alive on this flag. Does a great job. Gets the kill momentum. Keeps blue flag moving. XR5's flag is still out and about. He's got it now over halfway. Shots coming in from below. Can he get the throw up to Slazy? No, he can't. Slazy now making a run for the flag. I don't think this was a good choice. He's surrounded by X5 players, and we've still got that flag out and about. Who's that on spawn? Brattles has just spawned on the flag. This is absolutely perfect for him. Can he make it happen? No, there are three members of X5 on his flag, and look at that momentum with the beatdown. The double from momentum. Oh, sweet baby Jesus. He's running it through mid-map now. He made it across. Bald is in a position to grab this one. Zerk on the recover as well. I honestly believe this could be it. Bald taken down.
He goes down.
They need somebody up top to cover the top. They need someone in position to make it happen. And look at this. That is going to be it. Oh, my word, ladies and gentlemen.
But Exile5 have done the impossible once again to the grand final winners of Season 1 of the ANZ Championships for Halo 5 Guardians. It is going to be Exile5, deservedly so. On behalf of the team here at ESL Australia behind the scenes, on behalf of my co-caster, Raph, I'm Maniac. We'll see you next time.